What's up, guys? It's Zenith with a quick little video today. I just wanted to briefly touch upon a topic I've talked about a lot actually in the past. Whenever I brought up the topic of a GameCube controller trigger, I usually always bring up this little metal piece that rests in the middle of your trigger. And although I do briefly describe it out each time, I never really dedicated too much time to it, so I figured I'd make a little quick video on the side to at least talk about it, maybe start some discussions, or just gain information about it. Because I did look this topic up online, and there isn't too much information about it. Now on your screen, you're seeing two different generations of Nintendo triggers. I'm just using this little metal brace as a stand for this one because it won't stand upright. But on your left, you have a representation of older triggers, and on the right, you have the newer triggers. As I've mentioned in my previous videos, and as you can see on your screen, there's absolutely no difference between these two. The one on the left is just made of a darker plastic, and the older generation controllers do have this. Within the control stick, the X, Y, and the triggers, they're all made of a darker gray than the new ones. But if you can tell when I bring this up close, the moldings of the bottom parts of the controllers are the exact same. Literally, the only missing piece is this metal brace. In fact, on the newer controllers, they do even have this little molding that the old ones have that are meant to actually hold the metal brace. So throughout the generations, the only difference between the triggers are that the color of the plastic changed, the length of the spring may vary, and it may or may not come with this little metal brace. I know that all the really old first few generations of controllers do come with the metal brace. I'm talking the classic silver controller, the indigo, the first black controller, and I do believe the teal, orange, and clear controllers. I'm not sure about the really specific rare ones, like Symphonic Green, the Resident Evil one, the Panasonic controller. I'm not sure if those specifically have these little metal braces with them. I'm also not sure on the manufacturing date of those, but at some point in their timeline, I'm sure to cut down on costs, they did take this little metal piece out. I own a few of the Club Nintendo controllers, and those did not come with the metal brace. I'm not sure if they're ever opened in the past because I bought them used, but that's actually another common problem with finding these little metal braces, because I'm pretty sure other players are looking for them, and I have bought a clear controller used in the past. And while I'm pretty sure the clear controllers do come with this little metal brace, the one I bought did not have them. I'm pretty sure that's just a result of the previous owner just taking them out before they resold it. I think the white controllers with the GameCube logo on it that were made in Japan also don't have it, and the only way to get reliable new controllers today, which is these Smash 4 logo controllers, these all don't have it. Now you might be wondering, why is this such a big deal? Why is this like a video topic? And for the mass majority of people who buy these controllers, it's actually not a big deal at all. I hate using the term, but for casual players, people who just play when their friends come over to their place or whatever, those kind of players are not going to notice a subtle difference at all. But for people who want to play the game competitively and are willing to spend the time and resources to get the best feeling controller they can possibly get, this does make a big impact. Now, because the majority of the market won't notice the slight difference, that is why I think Nintendo took this little piece out. There's no point in continuing to manufacture these little pieces if the controller can do fine without it. But as I've seen on forums and other videos, this actually does pose kind of a problem with competitive players. They find that the triggers stick every once in a while as a result of this. This metal piece really just helps the trigger go down straight all the way. So without it, the trigger can move back slightly and stick to the casing of the controller. So yeah, it's for this reason that competitive players really just look for these little parts. And it is a shame that there's no reliable way to get these little pieces in today's market, because the new controllers don't have them, and the old controllers you might get on eBay might come without it. Now there's a question I did want to ask. This is just literally a piece of thin metal that's shaped in this specific way. And because this is kind of actually such a big deal, and a lot of players do look for these, I was actually really wondering if there's any manufacturer, or if there's anybody out there with the capabilities of producing these themselves. I'm sure they're not too costly to make, even if Nintendo thought it'd be worth it to take it out of their production, but it would be really interesting if somebody were able to produce these and sell it to actual players, who then wouldn't need to worry about finding another pair of metal braces for another controller they might get. I don't know, man, it's just kind of a shame that they took these little pieces out, because it makes it pretty inconvenient to try to build a new controller or just to find in general. So yeah, thanks for watching my little rambling video. I just wanted to address this topic because I didn't really feel like I would have time to really pick at this in a video with another topic that just happens to contain a trigger in it. So if you found this interesting, or you might know how to produce these or anything like that, please contact me or leave a comment below, because I do feel this would actually help a lot of players. It would help newer controllers not stick, and overall I really don't think it'd cost too much. So yeah guys, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video, which will hopefully be a longer video on an actual bigger subject. See you next time.